The warden spoke to me again, but I wasn't really listening anymore. Then he said, "I expect you'd like to see your mother." I stood up without saying anything and he led the way to the door. On our way downstairs, he explained, "We've transferred her to our little mortuary so as not to upset the others. Every time one of the inmates dies, the others feel uneasy for a day or two, and that makes life difficult for the staff." We crossed the courtyard and there was lots of people chatting in little groups. They stopped talking as we went by, and then behind us the conversations would start up again. It was like muted chatter of budgery girls. At the door of a small building, the warden stopped. "I'll leave you now, Mr. Musso. If you need me for anything, I'll be in my office." We arranged the funeral for, as usual, 10 o'clock in the morning. We thought that would enable you to watch over the departed tonight. One other thing. Your mother apparently often mentioned to her friends that she wished to be buried in a religious funeral. I've taken it upon myself to make the necessary arrangements."
So have you done much modelling before?
No.
Yeah, but you go to art college, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, have you had people model for you?
Sure. I mean, we have a class called life drawing. So our teacher gets us people to come and pose for us.
Okay, well, you know what I'm trying to achieve then?
Yeah.
This place is pretty big, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
It's an old warehouse, that's why it's all wired up and things.
Yeah.
They don't charge any rent, so I'm sure they don't mind me borrowing some electricity. You want to change over there? I'm done. It's okay.
Wow. That was a lot quicker than I thought it would
be. Yeah.
Could I have a look?
No, you can go now.
Okay.
You can go. Yeah, I almost forgot.
Oh, you could have just given this to me when we finish.
Yeah. You'll be all right from here?
Sure, I'll be grand.
Yeah. Thank you.
was true. When she was at home, Mother used to spend all her time watching me in silence. She cried a lot for the first few days in the old people's home, but that was only because she wasn't used to it. After a month or two, she'd have cried if she'd have been taken out of the home, because by then she was used to it. That's partly why during the last year I hardly ever went to see her anymore.